Hello, everybody, and welcome back to episode 2 of PolyLive. For those of you tuning in live with us tonight, be prepared. It's not going to be your computer on repeat, as it is a live show. We may choose to do a couple retakes of some content for tonight's show, so don't freak out. If anything, you'll get to see more of us, which is usually always a good thing. But without further ado, welcome back to PolyLive for episode 2 of season 4. Alongside Ashley Avonk, again, I'm Michael Gershow. We're happy to have you tuning in for another exciting live show. We are doing something a little new, little new and scary for us up here. We are in front of a live studio audience. Let's hear for the live studio audience tonight, everybody. I've never felt more excited and scared at the exact same time. But we're going to do our best for you all tonight. Again, it is a live show, so as you have questions, maybe for us or for our awesome guests, which we'll get to in a little bit, please send them in. We have two moderators to weed through some of the bad questions and to get us the best ones. Brandon and Drew, everyone in the audience, say hi to Brandon and Drew for us. We'll work on that for next time. But we mentioned we do have a kind of a new structure going on, so we want a lot more of what you all at home want to see on our show. We reached out over the last couple weeks to a lot of clubs here at Cal Poly, and we're going to hear from a few of them in a little bit. If you are out there as part of a club or an organization and you'd like to get highlighted on a future Poly Live show, we'll have more information for you coming up a little later. Ashley, how have you been?
I've been good.
We did show one, what was it, a month ago?
A month ago.
It seems like yesterday.
It does.
And you've been well?
I've been well.
Kind of business as usual? Or?
Yeah, you know, going with the flow.
Getting ready for a nice Thanksgiving break, hopefully.
Of course. What are you doing over Thanksgiving?
I'm going home. I haven't been home in a long time. I kind of feel a little bad. You know, haven't seen the old mom and pop in a while. So
there you go.
Kind of just ready to relax a little bit, gear up for some finals.
Very yourself? Nice. I'm super excited to gain 5 pounds when I go home for about 4 days. So
just five? Right. Are you skipping Thanksgiving?
It's definitely just skipping.
Okay, I go home and I eat Thanksgiving for dinner and then for breakfast
okay.
and then for lunch through about Sunday afternoon.
Okay.
That's just how I roll.
Okay.
I don't,
I'm trying to cut it down a little
I
bit.
Guess 5 pounds
the
exception.
This year, but we'll see how it goes.
Right on. That sounds fun, though.
It's going to be great.
Very cool. Well, let's get back to the show. As mentioned, we have a couple exciting organizations represented tonight. We have Friday Night Live, as well as ISIC, and we'll get to them in a bit. Again, shout out to our buddy Justin Batista, our field correspondent. We have a video from him. He's going to be highlighting a few lesser known, but awesome resources and spots here on campus. Again, we'll get to that in a little bit. Again, we're trying to give some shout outs to some clubs out there. So we're going to hear about the Horticulture Club. I knew I was going to stumble on
it's
it.
All right.
Here it came. But the Horticulture Club here on campus is open to any and all students interested in all aspects of horticulture. It sounds like they do a lot of events with a lot of other clubs or with themselves here on campus. Just last quarter, they had a barbecue. They were present at Farmers Market. Coming up next quarter, I'm going to go to these. If you all don't, I'll be there for sure. They have two speakers coming in. One is a local master gardener.
Wow.
Right?
Okay.
So I feel like if I'm going to learn from someone, let's make it a master gardener, you know?
Of course.
They're also going to invite someone from Kent State University who's been doing research out over there. And they have a field trip planned. They're going to the Seaside Gardens in Carpinteria, California. If that's not enough to sell you, I don't know what is. They also helped out this last quarter with the pumpkin carving party. Those are always fun, as well as the Cal Poly corn maze, which I know is always a huge hit here on campus. So shout out to the Horticulture Club. If you're looking to get involved with that, we'll have some more information on that later in the show.
Very nice. I also heard membership is free, so.
That's what I heard as well.
Might as well.
Which is always a good selling point for college students.
Very nice. And with that, I'm going to introduce our first guest. We have Claire from Friday Night Live. I always want to say Friday Night Lights, but I'm going to get it right. Come on over. Woo! There we go.
Hi.
Welcome.
Thank you.
How are you doing tonight?
I'm doing well.
Well, thank you for coming on the show. Can you explain a little bit of what Friday Night Live is?
Yeah, so Friday Night Live is a state partnership that counties have with California. So our county, San Luis Obispo, has a partnership for Friday Night Live. And at the high schools and middle schools, we do a lot of work. We have chapters of Friday Night Live at those schools, and it's a youth development program, really focusing on leadership in our community, activism with the youth. So it's an awesome, awesome program that we have in our county. And Cal Poly Friday Night Live is the first actual college chapter of Friday Night Live. So it's really cool.
Very nice.
Okay. The first pioneers.
First and the best, right?
Yeah, this is the fifth year of it here on our campus. So we promote healthy living activities for the students that are substance free. That's our main goal, but we also provide, again, leadership opportunities, working in our community and stuff like that.
Very nice. So you mentioned that you go to local middle schools and high schools. What kind of events do you do with them?
So, well, we do a lot of different events at the middle schools and high schools, as well as just, like I said, the chapters themselves, the students, like, getting involved in their community and community service and stuff like that. But, like, for one example, Morro Bay High School puts on every 15 minutes, which viewers might remember from if their high school participated in that.
Okay.
And the students are all organizing that with our county coordinators.
So. Very nice. Mm-hmm. And how can students on our campus get involved with your club?
So they can come to our club meetings, but also help volunteer at the events. Really, we all want to promote the message of healthy student living. And so just coming to our events and then getting involved in our club, which we have meetings right now this quarter, it's wrapping up. But they were this quarter, if anybody is still interested in coming to our last two.
It's never too late.
They're Fridays at noon in the health center, actually in the back by counseling services. It's room 153. It's the medical offices. But then we'll be advertising and kind of postering when our next meetings are going to be next quarter, because the time will change.
Okay, awesome. And then you have an upcoming event that's going to be happening at the beginning of next quarter.
Yes, we are very excited. It'll be our second annual Awareness Week. It's January 7th through the 11th, so it's the first week of school when, you know, school's the buzz and all the students are on campus running around. So
there you go.
I definitely remember those days of standing
just
in line.
Just running around.
Yes, but... So we have different organizations on campus putting on events during the day and at night every day during the week.
Okay.
And so some of the organizations we're working with are, you know, Greek life orientation programs, some of the different clubs as well that we're working with. We have a couple clubs, like, and one program that everyone kind of remembers from, like, possibly their time during orientation. Aware, Wake, Alive is going to be putting on an event. Okay. Other groups on campus, SAFER is going to be putting something on, so as well as our club, Friday Night Live, we're going to be doing an event. So really it's just a time for all the students, you know, come get involved in different organizations on campus.
Very nice. And we actually have a question from our audience member, Chris. He asked about what other events Cal Poly Friday Night Live puts on.
So a couple of our other bigger events that we do, we have extravaganzas in housing.
Okay.
And those are really fun. They're like pretty much like big dances. They're awesome. We just had our Halloween extravaganza in Fremont Hall, and it was a costume party. We did a gross out table where the students had to like reach their hand into like gross like noodle, like cold noodles, and like try to find something. It was like, you know, a gag fun. But then we also had like a dance party. We did like mocktails with dry ice. And so we're just providing really awesome, fun activities that are substance free for the students.
Very cool. Mm-hmm.
Were those open to anyone living in university housing? Or
yes, those are open.
What about non-university housing students?
So that's what like our Awareness Week events are for. Are for everyone in the community. They're available for Cuesta students to come to campus and check out the events, but it's open to all.
Very inclusive, it sounds like.
Yeah.
Very nice. And then you also mentioned about the Awareness Week. So a club out there is like, oh my gosh, I need to have my club in this. Can they still join or is it too late?
They can. Okay. If they want to put on an event, the event is totally up to them. They just email me and then we'll figure it out, kind of the basis of how it's going to work. And then we advertise it, Friday Night Live does. So we include them on our posters and everything like that. So if any club does want to still get involved, they can email me. Can I say my email right now? Is that fine?
Why not? You know?
It's just Claire. CLAIRE at slowfnl.com.
Very nice.
Pretty easy.
Pretty.
Yeah.
They got it.
Awesome.
Very nice. And so what kind of events do the clubs usually do so that the clubs can start, you know, thinking of what they want to put on?
So in the past, we've had a movie night, which was extremely successful. We've also, this one group on campus that's going to be doing, or it's the peer health education teams, they're going to be doing a trivia night that's inclusive of all the different peer health education teams and like what they each focus on. Mm-hmm. So that'll be a really awesome like trivia night for all the students to come do stuff, and then they'll also learn about the different teams as well. So those are some of the different events.
I also heard something about Minute to Win It earlier.
Yes, so Cal Poly FNL is looking at doing like a Minute to Win It activities throughout an entire day, and then having like a leaderboard, and then that person could, you know, win a prize.
Okay, because competition
is going to get fierce.
It is.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I always practice Minute to Win It when I watch the TV show, and I'm really good.
Is that frowned upon, practicing beforehand?
No,
absolutely not.
Or like
you can
strategy. Prepare yourself?
That's right.
Well, it's like I'm a competitive person, so I'm going to get involved in something I know I'm good at. So
make sure you hit the scale of it, right?
I'll just be judging, though. I won't be playing.
Okay.
Yeah.
But if you want to be on the winning team.
Okay, I'll let you know.
Okay.
We can work together.
Very nice. Well, do you have any other questions about Friday Night Live or anything like that?
I don't think so. I've learned a lot just in the last few minutes.
I know, me too.
Yeah. I had heard about it last year and was fortunate enough to stop by Awareness Week last year. It sounds like it might even be a little bigger, a little better. I don't want to set the stage too high for you, but it sounds fun. I'll be looking forward to it.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much for coming in, Claire.
Thank you for having me.
Of course.
Yeah, there we go. They're learning.
And with that, I'd like to invite our archive viewers to, we're going to have a short cut to Justin's video about different spots around Cal Poly's campus.
Hey, everyone. Hope your quarter is going well. So on tonight's episode, I was tasked with the problem of trying to find some places that most Cal Poly students don't know about. So I hope all you guys recognize Musty right here. But how about I show you five places that you probably didn't know were here at Cal Poly. I'm across the street from Cal Poly's Orchard. Here they host the event called U-Pick. Every Saturday from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. You can come down here and pick your own fresh fruit for your enjoyment. Unfortunately, today it was raining, so they didn't have the event today. But every Saturday, fall, winter, and spring quarter, come check it out, pick your own fresh fruit, and have a good time doing it. I'm here at what some people call Pride Rock. It's pretty much just a little pond area near the business building at Cal Poly. And it's just a nice place to study, hang out. It's pretty quiet, pretty relaxing. So if you're looking for a place to hang out or just chill for a little while, you can come check this place out, because not too many people know about it. I'm outside the Cal Poly Cat Shelter, one of the more unknown places on campus. So let's go inside and take a look.
The Cal Poly Cat Program is an on-campus cat shelter that's non-euthanizing. So we're a cage-free, non-euthanizing environment for cats only. We're located two buildings down from the Rose Float building, which is by the H1 area. So we're located by the Pick Your Own for the fruit and vegetables, as well as where the Rose Float and Mechanical buildings are located. So we're close on campus, we're welcome for anyone that wants to come in, and we're always looking for volunteers. We don't only look for volunteers to assist with cleaning the shelter, but we look for volunteers that can come and socialize the animals. So if you're having a very stressful day, you could come into the shelter and just socialize with some of the kittens we have, so you could release your stress by petting cats for an hour. Which really isn't a benefit, isn't a loss to anyone, it's a benefit to both sides.
What are your hours?
We don't have set hours. This is entirely volunteer run, so it's whenever volunteers can show up. Generally, we have volunteers here from 8 a.m. until probably 10 or 11 in the morning, and then from 5 until probably 7:30 or 8.
How can you, like, start volunteering here?
For anyone that's interested in volunteering, we do have a site both on the Cal Poly site as well as a Facebook site for the Cal Poly Cat Program. And anyone that messages us, we're more than happy to train in volunteering.
I'm outside of Cal Poly's Leaning Pines Arboretum, and here you can find a bunch of different exotic plants. It's a really nice place to just come chill, hang out. You can study out here. It's pretty quiet some of the times. But if you're really interested in plants or just a nice place to study, come out and check it out. It's always a good
So here at Pulse, we have a massage chair, and it's a 15-minute massage. You can come in anytime between 8 and 4, Monday through Friday, and just make an appointment. You can do a walk-in, or you can come in and schedule an appointment, and we'll see what's available. When you come in here, it's important to keep in mind that you need to bring your Poly ID, and you need to bring socks. because we like to keep the chair clean. After everybody uses the massage chair, we always wipe it down and everything's kept sterile, and we want to make sure it's just a clean environment.
Cool. So first, when we get a patient in, we give them shoe covers and caps in order to keep the massage chair clean. We then walk the student inside. We have them take off any earrings or nose rings or anything like that. When they sit down, we give them different things to listen to. You can listen to the ocean, or we also have waterfall sounds, many other sounds as well. And then we sit the student down, and we have three settings. There's the Swedish deep in Shiatsu, and the Swedish is the lightest, and that's what we usually start most students off with.
All right, everyone, so there you have it, the five most unknown things on campus. Hope you guys have a good Thanksgiving, and I'm going to go ahead and get my massage on.
Open Gangnam Style. Gangnam Style.
Another club here on Cal Poly's campus, the Society of Women Engineers. Cal Poly Society of Women Engineers is here to support women in a lot of different fields, including science, technology, engineering, and math, to name a few. Looks like they offer support by providing scholarships, having industry members present at their meetings, that's always awesome, as well as creating bonds during social events and inspiring younger generations through outreach. For more information about the Society of Women Engineers here at Cal Poly, please feel free to check out swe.calpoly.edu. They're another group on campus that I hear about all the time.
Really?
I feel like with events and with opportunities. Sounds like we should check them out.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not even an engineer and I want to look it up. So.
It sounds like they're not going to bar you, you know? Like science, you can get pretty creative with
okay,
that.
Okay, very yeah. true, very right? true. And with that, we actually have another club called Colleges Against Cancer. Just side note,
right.
that last club, can men join? Do you know?
I believe they can. I've heard that you certainly can.
Okay.
Yeah.
Perfect.
The answer is a resounding yes.
Okay. Awesome. And with that, we're going to segue back into the other club.
There we go.
So Colleges Against Cancer, I really wanted to talk about this one because they do a really nice event called Relay for Life, which I don't know if you've heard of that. It
happens, that's a big time one.
It is. Yeah. It happens all throughout the nation. And we have one right here on Cal Poly's campus in May. And the Colleges Against Cancer actually have a club or a team that they have for a Relay for Life, which is a 24-hour race. But I say race like this because you actually don't have to run, which is why I like
so
it.
So it's my kind of race.
Yeah, okay. It's our kind of race.
There we go.
The walking race.
Yeah.
It's also themed laps, so another excuse for us to dress up, which we do
as if
often.
I needed one more.
And they do it to honor, support, and raise money for cancer research in patients with cancer. They also have an event called the Great American Smokeout, which is to get people to stop smoking. And it's going to be
very
happening
cool.
on November 29th. So I definitely am all for it.
Yeah, smoking's bad. So let's be straightforward about that.
There you go.
You know what I mean?
Cut to the chase.
Yeah. Well, help me, everyone here in the studio, in welcoming our next guests. We have Alex Williams and Richard Bauer here from ISIC.
Very nice. Woo!
How's it going?
Good evening. Doing well. How are you?
Pretty good. Thank you for having
me. Just pretty good?
Doing stupendous.
There we
stupendous.
Go, right? See what PolyLive can do for you. Before we get into what ISIC is all about, maybe introduce yourselves and what you study, maybe how long you've been here at Cal Poly.
Okay. So I am a fourth year international business major, one of the last few here.
There you go.
I'm proud of it. And I'm doing a minor in economics and taking some Mandarin courses. So
a little bit of everything.
A little bit of everything.
There's not much you're not doing, it sounds
yeah.
like.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I am the local committee president of ISIC SLO right now.
Right on. And Richard?
I'm a fifth-year aerospace engineer with a minor in multidisciplinary design. I've been in ISIC for 5 years, so my entire college career. And I'm the vice president of talent management.
There you go. Very cool. Well, Jen, let's just jump right into it. What is ISIC? What are you all about? What are some of the highlights of the club?
Okay. So ISIC was started in 1948 in the Netherlands. It was started right after World War II because a group of individuals looked at kind of the atrocities caused by World War II, and they found the root cause of World War II to be cultural ignorance and lack of
okay.
a global mindset.
Yeah.
So they found the best way to provide those opportunities to provide the global mindset and cultural intelligence to the youth around the world was through international exchange, particularly internships.
Right.
So that people could develop themselves personally and professionally.
Okay.
So from that, now we are currently present in 113 countries and territories with 89,000 members and over 1 million alumni.
Wow.
So we've come a long way, done a lot of exchange, and impacted a lot of lives.
So let me backtrack a little bit. I'm saying ISIC as if it's its own standalone word, but does it stand for something? Is it an acronym?
It is. It's a French acronym. It's no longer used anymore, but it used to be the International Association of Students in the Sciences, Economics, and Commerce.
So definitely a mouthful.
Yeah. Yeah.
There
you go. Now we just use ISIC for branding purposes. But as far as ISIC is concerned, on an international basis, we do internships, we do leadership development, international conferences, things like that.
So maybe what specifically can a Cal Poly student expect to get out of his or her participation with your club here on campus?
Okay. So not only do we have those conferences that I was talking about, we have regional conferences, we have national conferences, which is all of the local committees across the nation. We actually have one coming up in the end of December in Indianapolis.
Okay, right.
So we're going to have, we're going to have all 43 local committees there at one time. It's going to be over 600 members, delegates from, right now it's about 21 different countries.
Oh, that's awesome.
So a lot of networking opportunities. Besides the networking opportunities and the conferences, there's leadership development. Anything you would imagine, you have it. It gives you practical, real-world business skills such as sales, business development, marketing, PR, finance, you name it, we can probably provide it
right.
for you.
So. And it sounds like even more so, it would be on an international scale, not just what you might get here domestically, but then with all those complexities as well.
Oh, yeah.
Very nice. So let's say I'm interested in ISIC, which of course I am. How does one get involved? Is there a sign-up process or an interview, or is it for open membership?
Yes, there's actually an application process in 1 1/4. During the first few weeks, how it goes about is we have information booths at both UU Plaza and Dexter Lawn.
Okay.
We look for general members, we look for people who are fun, innovative, ambitious.
There you go, right?
That's
like you all over.
Oh, thanks.
Any year, any major. For the exchange participants, similar, fun, ambitious. We primarily look for people who are going abroad during the summer for 1 1/4 recruitment. And how the application process goes for new members is for the first 2 weeks is information booth, information session.
Mm-hmm.
Information session is usually in a classroom here on campus, last bit 30, 45 minutes, learn more about the organization, et cetera, et cetera. Then we have an application process, lasts about a week, where people fill out applications online.
Yeah.
Then Alex and myself, or the president and vice president of talent management, go through all the applications. We narrow down that pool to, a few individuals who go on to the interview stage. And then at the interview stage, the executive board is there. We interview the potential applicant. If they make it past that, then they are inducted into ISIC.
Okay. So it sounds like, students who end up as a part of the club are pretty driven, and they kind of know they want to be involved with it. You mentioned you're looking for students typically to go abroad over the summer.
For the exchange participants, yes. People who want to go abroad.
But not necessarily, that you don't have to go abroad
Correct.
Over the summer to get involved.
Correct.
Fantastic. So maybe once you mentioned there's an exchange participant kind of role that some of your members take on. So what would be kind of something that a student who would be interested in that would be trying to achieve?
Okay, so essentially what we're looking more so than anything is that kind of balance between personal and professional development.
Okay.
Kind of challenging yourself, going out of your comfort zone,
right.
having those lifelong experiences that will kind of change the way that you perceive the world, perceive other cultures, things like that. I know tons of people, one of my good friends went to Jordan, and another friend went to Cairo, Egypt, when there was the revolution. So she was actually a part of that. And that just, she has good friends from Egypt, and that changed her life forever. So
absolutely.
Really just people who are willing to take a challenge. And the important thing is that more so than what you're doing, it's just the fact that you challenge yourself to go abroad. That's what companies really look at more so than anything. It's just you could do an internship with Johnson & Johnson, or no matter what you do abroad, if you go somewhere like Vietnam or Egypt or something like that, then that really makes more of an impact.
And have either of you two taken advantage of that and gone abroad?
Yes.
I have. I actually got back from Vietnam on September 11th because, I like to live dangerously, so I got back on September 11th. And, basically I had an 8-week internship in Vietnam, in Hanoi, and I worked for an NGO to design a corporate membership program so that they could gain added support and revenues for the organization so that they could help foster environmental sustainability and social entrepreneurship in Vietnam. So then after that 8-week internship, I actually spent 1 week in Cambodia and 1 week in Thailand.
Oh, that's great.
And yeah, met a lot of good friends along the way.
So. And do you expect to go back to those places eventually?
Absolutely. After I graduate, I'm actually planning on doing my master's in Taiwan.
Well, there you go. You know, get right back to it. Yeah. We have a few audience questions coming in. Travis wants to know, do you pay for these conferences, or perhaps does the club maybe help you out with some portion of that?
Yes, you do pay for conferences. We try to provide stipends wherever possible, but it is a nonprofit organization.
Of course.
So the profits that we can lend to members is a little bit limited until we grow more. Then that increases our leverage to allow people to go to conferences. We do try to minimize costs, though.
Of course.
Especially the regional conferences are the least expensive, the most bang for your buck conferences.
Okay.
And then the national conferences are a bit more pricey, but it really, that opens you up to the entire network rather than just the West Coast.
So you're getting what you're paying for.
Absolutely.
And you mentioned some regional conferences. Are those perhaps here in the States? Jess in the audience wants to know if there's opportunities to stay here within the United States through ISIC.
Currently not, just because we are doing those international opportunities.
Right.
And you don't really so much expand your cultural mindset by staying in the same culture. I know that it is a very diverse country.
Yeah.
But you can build on that diversity just by going to a national conference and talking to people from all around the United States.
Absolutely. And then one more question from our audience. Jenna would like to know if you can be a part for the leadership experience but not go abroad. So maybe you're just looking for certain parts of the club, but maybe not all of them in one.
Absolutely. Yes, that's one of the primary things we offer in the ISIC organization is just being part of the organization itself.
Right.
You gain those valuable leadership experiences.
Okay. Like,
for instance, I manage between 40 and 50 individuals on any given basis. We have a website developer. You know, you name it, your major, we can give you leadership experience that will help you better that major.
So you'll kind of tailor it to specific
students. Absolutely.
That's great. Well, thank you both for joining us so much today. And thank you, those of you out there asking the questions. If we can give them a big round of applause. Thank you again, Alex and Richard with ISIC.
Thank you so much.
Thank you guys.
That sounds like a great opportunity to get involved, not only on our campus, but outside in the, you know, the rest of the world that a lot of people wouldn't be able to go to normally.
Yeah, I've been telling a lot of people, you know, I got to graduate in June, and I think the one thing really looking back that I wish I had made time for was to do some sort of study abroad or some sort of international experience.
Mm-hmm. Never too late.
So fingers crossed we can still, you know, do it for myself moving forward. But for all of those out there who still have time, consider it.
Yeah, very nice. And with that, we also have another really awesome club shout out that's actually involved a little bit in Greek life. We have the co-ed honor fraternity called Alpha Zeta. They do industry tours through the College of Agriculture. So they're really looking for students who have a really high GPA. They're looking for 3.0 and above, who are students within the College of Agriculture. What's really cool is that they do a lot of community service in SLO. And
that's always
as well
fun.
As, I know.
Yeah.
I mean, who doesn't want to build houses for people? They also do a lot of networking, and they were named the second small club of the year by the College of Ag. So, hey.
Kudos to
them.
You, Alpha Zeta.
Yeah.
Right?
And they also said it's a really great resume builder, which, I mean, it looks like being involved in an honor fraternity looks like a great resume builder,
yeah.
As well as leadership, involvement, outreaching, and long-lasting friendships, which everybody wants.
That's fingers crossed that you and I will work out. You know?
Yeah.
Still hoping for that.
We're looking. And with that, we'd like to wrap up our show and let you know that our next episode is on Monday, January 21st. At 3 o'clock p.m.
3 o'clock on a Monday?
3 o'clock on
a Monday. What if I have class at 3 o'clock on a Monday? How am I going to tune into my favorite live show?
Don't you worry. It's actually Martin Luther King Jr.'s B-Day. I know. We already thought of that.
So our Cal Poly students will have the holiday. They'll be
and
able
they
to
can
tune
watch
in.
This.
That's
Because that's what they want to do when they don't have school.
Right.
And then also another reminder to watch Justin's video, which will also be on our archive as well as our YouTube channel.
Yeah. Be sure to check that out.
Yeah. And if you were watching the show today and were like, my club needs to be sitting right here in these blue seats. Don't you worry. You can email us at orientations.calpoly.edu and tell us about your club. Get your club featured on our show. Win-win.
Yeah. And then in coming to the show like our live audience today has done, they've set themselves up to potentially win a free sweatshirt. And so we're going to invite Scott to come on in. We're going to have a drawing. Let's hear it for Scott, everybody.
Woo! All right,
after
I'm gonna collect this, and you're gonna pick it.
Okay.
No pressure.
And I put like 8 of my own name in, right?
Only 6.
Okay, good. Give everyone a fair chance.
Okay. Da 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 da.
Okay. It looks like the big winner for tonight's show is Jessica Montalban.
Woo!
Round of applause for Jessica Montalban.
Very nice. And with that, I'd like to sign off and say I'm Ashley and this is Michael. And thank you so much for watching our show today. Hope you got a great overview of some of the great clubs we have on our campus, as well as some different opportunities of things that you can be involved in.
We'll see you next time.